So far, you've researched browser events, and you've taken a peek at them being logged. Now it's time to actually listen for and respond to them with jQuery. There are three items you need in order to listen for events and react to them. You need the target element to listen to, the event we want to react to, and the actions to take in response. Let me show you an example. I need the target element that jQuery will be listening to for events, so I'll use jQuery to select the input field. Next, I call the on method. This on method is where the magic happens. It's the primary way that jQuery uses to set up event listeners. The first argument to the on method is the event I want to listen for. In this example, it's keypress, but it could also be click, change, and mouseover to name a few. And finally, I need to pass a function with the actions I want to happen in response. This function is called a callback. The callback function being passed to the on method is just a regular JavaScript function, and therefore can contain any JavaScript code you want, from altering page content to analytics code. I'll change the contents of the function to alter the color of the page. And I'll test it. Bam! Looks good! In the next quiz, you're going to create your own event listener.